mean, I'm just the recording. Hello, everyone. Welcome to week five against the Houston Texans and the Atlanta Falcons. Me and Dawson on two ends of the spectrum this year in Madden. Here we go, boys. The Georgia Bulldogs against the Houston Texans.
Don't you fucking say that about me.
Right. Cordarrelle Patterson to return it, bringing it out of the end zone.
And a good return as he'll be stopped just there, Satan. They are Satan.
Old dirty birds.
Here's the eighth overall pick from Texas. It's Bijan Robinson. What if you want to run into both fucking linemen?
Right.
You might have got four instead of three.
Defense for these Texans. They are the 22nd ranked unit against the run in the NFL.
When people talk about facing a challenge, they are
certainly don't you love that? Don't you just love a good user game?
But that shot I took at him yesterday.
What'd you say?
Burn said about running the ball.
Oh, no.
Not Burn, but Brad or Gary. I can't remember which one it was.
Yeah, I saw that, but I didn't even put it together.
What the fuck are you doing, Drake London?
What is he doing?
He got his initial block, and I guess he did what he was supposed to do. Avoiding the block in the back, but he looked goofy as fuck while doing it. He was fucking running behind the guy that made the tackle, like chopping his feet. On first down, Ritter. Escaping the pressure right. Hey, I don't know what made him actually slide that time, but instead of diving.
I think you have to go down on the pad or whatever.
The captain Bijan.
Did you make him captain? Or was he already?
No, I made him captain. I had a couple still open.
Terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. Oh, how about this on first and goal?
Oh, fucking Desmond Ridder. It's like he ran straight slant route.
Yeah.
Taylor's shot from the 9 on second and goal. Back to throw, Ritter. It's caught on the right side by Robinson. A good display of footwork. It gets him just inside the 5 to the 4.
Shit.
Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this 4 down territory? Might he go for it?
Big play coming here. It's 3rd and goal.
Ooh, what a stop.
Thank you, sir. Toa Toa.
Oh, God. I've had so much, like, body gas between farts and burps the last, like, since yesterday. It's ridiculous.
Why?
I have no idea. No idea.
Is this a time to go for it, or is it a time to be a little bit cautious? I think in this case, he feels good about his team. He should go for it.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on 4th.
Damn it.
He's supposed to be driving a car. What the fuck is that?
Nah, oh, probably.
Is that Ricky Bobby?
Good. Yeah.
First and 10, it's Stroud. That's complete to Dell. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup.
It's 2 first downs. They've got to give their defense a chance to settle down, catch their breath a little bit after they give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. The man coming off a great rookie year, it's Damian Pierce. And he's able to take
super fast.
And you find a way to pick up first downs.
Stroud now on 1st and 10. To Pierce, they set up the screen. They'll get 4 there out of the screen, and it's 2nd down.
The ball on the ground. This is a passing league, so there's a conundrum for them. How do they get better defending the pass?
Stroud off the play fake.
Terrell, good play.
Thank you, brother.
Pass a touchdown of the year?
Yeah, literally.
Maybe I'm your break
for their next drive. Drive, it was all about the ground game.
Oh boy,
murdered that guy.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, dude. I had Rankins. I feel like he used to play for the Saints, and all them years ago when I was with Jesse, like in that franchise, I know you know which one I'm talking about. He was my defensive tackle that fucking dominated.
Ritter back to throw.
Good pass.
Thank you.
And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. With it after the play fake, sliding out of the pocket.
Oh my God, good play.
That was fucking lucky, is what that was.
Good play.
Hey, but what did dude say the other day? I'll take being lucky over what?
Yeah, lucky over being good.
He scored the touchdown earlier, and he's in phase right out of the gate. Right now, he's playing with such confidence. That they have an answer for him no matter what they do on defense. And here's another big play to prove his
power. Ah, goddamn, Julio. Would have had a play too.
Being knocked back
after the loss, they'll come up second and 13. This time, Ritter choosing to throw it.
Toa Toa, man, he is something else, honestly.
He's going to be good.
Mm-hmm.
If he has enough time to develop before he hits that kind of wall.
I think so.
You gonna play your next week game after this too?
Yeah. Oh my God! Come on, Jesus. Damn it. Good play by Bates.
Yeah, swap to a blitz late there.
Offense looks like they have a little extra pep in their step as they take the field here for drive number three, because remember, Charles, drives one and two both ended in the end zone.
Yeah, right now they just got to be careful not to lean into overconfidence, because every drive has a life of its own. I like the way that they started, the way that they're going about doing things right now. They've got a chance for that third consecutive touchdown, and that would be a crushing blow to the defense.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 36. On the counter, this is Robinson.
Ah, hell of a play by him. Whoever that was, I can't
Grenard.
See. Grenard, yeah.
At the line of scrimmage, brings up second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle. That's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game, because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
On second down, another shot for Robinson.
I gotta start using that fucking hard cut. I always forget about it.
Early down stuff will put this offense in precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big bodied guys in the middle of this day, has got to be priority one.
Gotta get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. Working from the gun, Ritter.
Fucking spied with him and it didn't work.
I was trying
to
juke.
Yeah.
He didn't juke when I juke. Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. A kind of a lucky break on the prior drive, Charles. The turnover on downs that the offense had didn't come back to bite them after the other side of their defense came through, was able to hold them without being sub. But maybe because they held them, they might go for it again.
Oh my God! Oh my God!
Throwing now is Stroud. Oh goddamn! It's Pierce, and he is going to have a Texans first down as the race play develops. He heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction.
Oh my God, come on. Robert Woods. Stroud to throw it. Lots of screen pass. That's complete. Breaks a tackle. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. Defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going? From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Singletary, they'll go up the middle. And he works his way forward. Stroud looking to throw. Got his man down. And that's going to be good for another first down. As it's up. On first down, here's Stroud. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Touchdown, Texas.
Hello.
Last time out, remember they fumbled the football. That led to the touchdown. And Charles, they were in the red zone. So oh my God. Tyler Big Dick Algier. Come on, boys. Fucking goddamn. Everybody just run into a goddamn block. How about it?
Second down and 8.
Ritter now looking to throw it this time. Got a man, it's Patterson complete. So no gain on the play. And 3rd and 8 now. They tried to swing it out left into the flat, but the defense, they were very principled there.
It felt very West Coast offense, didn't it? You know their expression, right? On a West Coast offense, when they throw the ball, it's either going to be a touchdown or a check down, meaning they like to press it downfield. If they don't have it, swing it out, which is exactly what we saw there. But how about the great pursuit and tackle to make a nice play?
Ready. The Falcons on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 8.
Ritter to throw it. Mr. Anderson.
Mr. Anderson. I went and got a massage one time, and these motherfuckers text me every goddamn day. We have an opening. We have an opening. We have an opening. Your preferred therapist has an opening. I'm like,
there's a shit fucking punt, too. With a backspin on it.
Oh, God. I don't know. Just some of the shit you say reminds me of a younger me. I was trying to get it to him on the field. Stroud now to throw. That's complete to Pierce. Stays on his feet. But he's gonna be out of bounds. Motherfucker. A throw out wide to Woods, complete. Down the sideline he goes.
Good play.
Thank you, brother.
Decided not to juke, because I knew you was trying to try to hit stick that motherfucker.
Oh yeah, 100%. That motherfucker. What?
Oh God!
My God! My God! That son of a bitch.
What? He is that dude.
Yeah. Look at this. One. He was on his back.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Looking to throw it here, Ritter.
Slide, motherfucker. Jesus. Put him in a goddamn blender right there.
Yeah. That was funny. Put him in a goddamn blender down there.
Ritter from the gun. He's gonna rifle one. Probably picked.
Nope.
It's gonna be knocked away and incomplete. Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there's not much to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
Now a second and 10.
Ritter will set up to throw it. Flush to his right. And incomplete on the deep ball. I know he was trying to get the completion downfield, but the way this game has gone, with a few of the runs he's made along the way, he should have kept it and taken it with his
feet downfield. What the hell was that? The shreds of defense. Instead, a nice one. I'm a quarterback.
I've got to throw it. I think that might have relieved
the pressure going on in you.
Everything that's happened, whatever it may be.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Ritter now. Escaping the pressure.
Should have threw that one away. I was trying. That's what my plan was, and then I passed the fucking line when I stepped up.
Oh, well.
That's because Ritter's got a little awareness, you know.
Yeah.
It's decision making.
Yeah.
Well, absolutely. They reached the end zone several times. The passing game. figured some stuff out.
Yeah, I need to get on there with you. It looks like a lot of fun. Good God. Uh-oh.
God damn, if we could fucking tackle.
God damn. Good play right there. That's what I'm saying, Calais. Mm-mm-mm. Got me. Yeah, that was the goal there. Although the first down would have been. First down would have been nice. I was like, I was trying to remember what side to kick it to based on my coverage, and I was really unsure.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17 yard line. Out there for their next drive, and their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out and establish a
that motherfucker is gonna be good.
Make no mistake about it though, kicking field goals not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone, but these guys gonna chop into that deficit. They got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Short throw caught by Pitts. And that's good for a gain of 6. And it brings up 3rd and 5 now. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
Ritter. Oh, shit. I just don't pump faked it to Kyle Pitts. He was running wide open.
Yep. I saw that.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Out of the gun, they give to Robinson. Oh, a heck of a move. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. So after 2 first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. Back to Robinson now on first down. And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Award that tackle for loss to the linebacker Denzel Perryman.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Sets up the screen to Robinson. And they'll work this
down. Light hit. Jesus Christ.
I don't know why he didn't one hand it like he did, you know, earlier in the year.
I know, what a bitch.
Catch it on his fucking hip.
What a bitch.
Lazy
dude.
Piece of shit, that's all he is.
Yeah.
Good for a gain of 5. Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure you're back. You spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
Ball on the 35. Here comes 2nd and 5.
Hey, hey,
Robinson up the middle. Give him four on the carry, and it'll make this a third and about two.
I don't care what the emphasis is in the NFL at any given time. Every defense is still going to say their number one goal every game is stop the run. And right now, they're not doing that, and that really chips away at your confidence.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Again, it's Robinson. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29.
And that's why you spend a first-round draft pick on a running back. Not for just the fancy runs, but these dirty, gritty third and ones, third and twos. That's why you draft him.
Here we go, set.
They run the option here on first and 10.
What the fuck? I held X to fuck give it.
I
don't know about you, but I'm going to go to the positive side this time. Yeah, there was a fumble at the end of this one, but what a sustained drive. And if they keep stringing those together, you got to like their chances.
And credit the defense, though. You're out there for that long, you start to get tired, but they were able to get the turnover.
Did you just credit the defense?
I like to credit the defense and the offense.
I like you.
And the analysts.
That's perfect.
Oh, what? I did not mean to call that play.
No matter, we can't tackle Pierce.
That was crazy. I did not mean to call that one. But worked out.
They still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
So from just across the midfield stripe, here's second and 9. A give up the middle to Singletary. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A yard in the wrong direction. Makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
I'll tell you what, this defense hasn't played its best, but they're still right in this football game. If they keep making plays just like that, they're going to give their offense a chance.
Oh, great.
I tell you what, he can fucking hurt him. Oh, he's getting up off the ground.
God damn. That was hilarious.
And he's shoving the head down the whole time he's hurtling.
Oh, what an idiot. I was trying to pass it there. It didn't work, though, obviously, as you can see. Oh, my God.
Third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports as we are set to bring you the home stretch here, the fourth quarter.
That's hilarious.
The Texans send the punter out as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and it will be Falcon football.
timeout set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line. Their defense was able to force the punt. That's the good news. But this is still a two-score game, and they need points on this drive and in a relatively quick manner. Out of the gun, here's Ritter. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. That one doesn't find its target, but all in all, he's been much sharper this week. He was under 50% a week ago, and now he's up over 70%.
But you know it's standard for quarterbacks and receivers getting together for a little extra time each and every day in practice. I get the sense they got together for a lot of extra time this week to try and improve that passing percentage, and it's worked out quite well.
Faster. Ritter throwing on third down. He'll rifle this one deep right side.
God damn it! Fuck! Great. Fucking shit show. What is Will doing? Jogging.
Loaf.
Yeah.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Hand off to Robinson out of the shotgun. And good space to operate there as he takes this down inside the 35-yard line. And quickly, they get to the line. On first and 10, it's Robinson. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line.
How the fuck are you trying to break his leg, bro? So far
as his just trying to get it done.
Despite the score, he's trying to get down his career.
This guy, he's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
On first and 10, it's Algier. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Throw the fucking ball. God damn, Desmond.
The hard hitting safety Jimmy Ward picking up the sack that time.
And another long drive from the offense, but the defense is denying them the end zone. Nothing to show for the last drive offensively. They can't come away empty handed again.
Ritter and the Falcons need an answer and a big play here on third and long following the sack. Looking to throw.
Got me.
Oh. Alright. And probably not the last one they're going to see in this game, not as long as they hold this lead.
So here we go. Looking
this
kick of the game forthcoming from the right hash this
ain't no Bryce or Quinn, I tell you that. Oh my God! Oh, Jesus!
Fucking overcorrected for that wind.
Yeah, you corrected like it was an 8.
Well, it was a 7. Is what it might show.
I think. Let's see whenever this kickoff comes up. If he gives it to him. That was a 4.
What is it?
That's 4. For whatever reason, I thought it was 8. Fucking idiot.
You thought it was 8 for real?
Yeah, swear to God.
Oh my God.
Thought it said 8.
That's... Well.
Houston's offense already.
Don't matter, we got the points anyway.
Their lead back down to one score after the field goal a moment ago, so they'll be looking to string together a few first downs, likely on the ground as they begin first and 10. That's complete to Dell.
Played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Second and 6, just inside the 30. Running it out of the gun with Pierce. And he'll scratch out a yard up to the 30, and that's all. And the offense moving quickly on the line.
Oh, good stop. Good stop.
Thank God for Jesse Bates.
Yeah, right.
Kenny Pickett is blowing the game for the Steelers.
I see that.
Three picks. What a dog. Last time, let's see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles. I've never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you've met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
On second down, here's the option. Bro, fucking slide.
He will not slide.
Earlier he had green grass when he actually slid. Ever since then he's dove. Right there he got tripped, but that one wasn't his fault.
Oh yeah, he did.
He didn't fucking fumble.
He did trip.
Continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Robinson with another carry. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. 15 more there, and that will roll. It's another first down.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he's going to
motherfucker rolled 3 yards.
That's Tyler. He just likes them yards. Mr. Algier, he likes running that football. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently.
Trying to get me in the UMS shit.
I had the alignment I wanted. I said to myself, man, if they block this right,
yeah,
I'm at least getting a first down.
This is third and two. Maybe the biggest play in this football game. Robinson will try to
Fuck, I punched it. I punched it.
Oh, four goddamn fumbles.
I punched the shit out of that, dude. Holy fuck. Holy fuck. That was insane.
Four fucking fumbles.
Why am I? They're running off the field. You see that? The game's not over. Do you see this? Fucking dillweeds.
Defense, that grouchy guy,
Forget what the coaches said. I'll guarantee you, he told the quarterback, we just took care of you. Now you take care of us.
On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. Trenches never more important than right now. This is third and inches. He is going to have the first down, and that is going to suck the life right out of this crowd.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation and taking care of the football.
It ain't over yet, dog. Not even close.
I ain't mad at the results. I'm mad at the fucking fumbles.
Yeah.
Four of
them. Now to change things up, Stroud will throw it. Eluding the pressure right.
That was dumb on my part. My fucking controller keeps dying. You hear me? Okay.
Second and 10. A run for Pierce out of the gun.
There it goes.
And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. I guess he was saving his best for last, so to speak. Longest run of the day coming here in the fourth quarter right there.
And that type of run makes for a better night for him and his teammates, doesn't it? To be able to produce this late in the game can lead to some big smiles and satisfaction in the locker room after this one's over.
Hell of a game, Dawson. I know you're frustrated at the fucking turnovers.
5 points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down.
It wasn't even nothing that... outside of one that I could control, and the last one was a hell of a play. The other two are the ones I'm really mad at, the middle two.
Yeah.
You know you've got to run the football. They know you've got to run the football. Sometimes that means there's nowhere to run the football.
Second and 12, and you'd have to assume another all-out effort to stop the run is coming.
Like a guy who understands the situation. Also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
Eighth play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. Singletary, they'll go up the middle. And he'll be brought down at the 34, well short of the first down marker. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. The Texans send the punter out as he's on to kick it away. It's a 40-yard punt, 4 yards on the return. And the offense as they take over. Here we go. This is first and 10. Ritter looks to throw it. Pass complete to Robinson. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
I got the sense that the defense created a little momentum for him there, didn't they?
Did their job, forced the punt. Now, nice start to the drive. Offense has to do their part.
Yeah, they certainly do, but what a great start for them. They got to go thank the guys on D.
They'll come up now on second down. Here's Ritter.
What the fuck is Will doing? You see him floating out there?
Practice is practicing his witchcraft.
Yeah.
It was a strange locker room in Bama last year with Braswell, you know, in the corner chanting Latin. Anderson doing witchcraft.
This definitely four down territory at this point, but a critical third down here. Now Ritter. That's caught by Gibbs. Fourth down, big play. Here's Ritter. Pass taken in. He will have the conversion on fourth down. He's out of bounds as well to keep their hopes alive. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down.
They like ran into one another. Did you see that?
Drake London was running slants and he just stopped.
I was confused about that one.
Another try, second and 10 now. Throwing now is Ritter.
Well, good fucking game, dude.
That was a long shot, but they did get one final chance to try to score to overcome this. No touchdown, though, Charles. And that brings this one to a close.
Go win a Super Bowl, Dawson. Hell, you might.
Straight losses, and they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for Atlanta,
Bijan played out of his fucking mind. Desmond had 92 rush yards but 3 fumbles.
To redeem themselves at home next week.
Every time we get a good drive going, they fucking fall.
Yep.
Guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
Yep, see y'all next week.